My name's Alexander.
I'm Abby.
Western Australia.
It's been a dream of mine.
Perfect opportunity, especially along with underwater photography.
Really love the opportunity.
And it's the other side of the bloody world.
Hello everyone, my name's Liam. I live down in sunny Cornwall, where I'm a full-time baker. All of my free time, I'm out exploring the depths of Cornwall. I live and breathe photography, as you might have noticed if you've come across my Instagram page. Yeah, I'm just obsessed with it.
You gonna miss Daddy?
Yeah.
Is he going on a big holiday?
Yeah.
Where's he going?
To Australia.
Was my gate number 6?
Flying Qatar Airways made the long journey seem really easy.
I go to sleep in England, wake up in Australia. Well, we're in Perth now, we're at Elizabeth Quay. I'm really excited for today, actually.
What we like to do on our tours is showcase those little hidden gems that you might not find on your own.
Yeah, we're so lucky there's art everywhere.
We've got a hell of a lot of stuff to cram in today.
So we're at the State Building, and apparently this is the place to be.
People of Perth are a very mixed bunch. You see all walks of life there, which is so cool. So many different nations all like living together and, you know, just getting along absolutely fine. We met a guy called Walter. Straight away went into like the history of the indigenous people and how people are trying to make things right for past wrongdoings.
We are the Noongar Bibbaman people. What I'll do for you now is I'll give you welcome to country.
How you doing, Russell?
Hey, Liam, how you going, mate?
Well, no pressure, but we're going to catch some fish. It's like when you come to Rottnest, even though it's about 20 k's off the coast of Perth,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
like coming to another planet. The other thing about Perth is the culture of Perth, the lifestyle in Perth, it's a lot more relaxed. The food culture, being a chef, the food culture over here is amazing. We've got incredible ingredients. I got a fish. Here we go. So that's a little silver brim, little cutie.
Yeah, so after a spot of fishing, Russell took us to one of his restaurants. Yeah, we got to try some of his famous Russell food, which was absolutely delicious.
The saltbush on the prawns is indigenous.
Yeah.
It's
yeah,
a local
yeah.
forage product. Look, they're all pretty hot. They're all pretty hot. You know, you got to go.
Which was absolutely delicious. Yeah, and we all left very full and very happy.
Well, we're on our way to Ningaloo. We're about 20 minutes out.
My first impression of Brooke was that she was super chilled, super laid back.
I'm a photographer based on the Ningaloo Reef in Western Australia. This is a really special piece of coastline on the Western Australian coast. There's a lot of beautiful things that you can see here, and it's just so pristine. It's so untouched. I would say I'm pretty obsessed with living here. It's one of those places that really gets under your skin. Once you come here, it's really hard to leave. As a photographer, it's a great place to sort of grow a portfolio. Just have that amazing content that we can capture here.
So stupidly, I think after a beer, we'd all decided that we were going to get up at 5 a.m.
Morning. Apparently, we're going to go look at some turtles.
So it was early morning, the light was really beautiful, and like the first thing we saw was just loads of turtles. A quick drive down to Yardy Creek, and then we hopped on a boat, and yeah, we just saw all sorts of cool wildlife. I actually got some of my favourite shots.
Normally try and shoot with the sun always behind me.
Okay, talking to her and Ollie is like, I definitely want to get into underwater photography. So we were all a bit dubious about whether we were actually going to see some stuff or not. Pointed up and showed us the spotter plate.
I am a sunny and I have just picked up a whale south at
Tiffany had spotted three different whale sharks. It was at that point we were starting to get like really excited.
Yeah.
It was a crazy experience.
You go first and then we'll jump in up.
As soon as you were underwater with that animal, it was like really calm because you couldn't hear anything. Then you were just paused in time, just sharing a little moment with the most crazy animal.
Could just see the look on his face. He was pretty happy about today's adventure.
Yeah, I can barely talk. I literally am a bit like shaky.
One of the coolest things I've ever seen in my life. It's so unreal. It's been a whirlwind. Yeah. It was like one of the best things I've done in my life. All of this.
Yeah. I'm really excited.
You're on, you've got my line.
November to have a whale shark.
Every single part of it was just like adventure after adventure after adventure. And it was just, yeah, it was amazing. I just want to do it over and over again. And again, and again.